As the name implies, with hue saturation, you can adjust two of the three color components, hue and saturation. In fact, you can even adjust value, but not in the advanced way, as you can with levels or curves. Each tool has its own speciality and unique way of working. I have opened Organ. Let's have a look at saturation. I would like to adjust the saturation of this image. To open Hue Saturation, I go to Colors, Hue Saturation, or I press Ctrl U. If I increase saturation, I will shift pastel colors more to saturated colors. Let's see if we can improve this image by increasing its saturation. I drag the saturation slider to the right. If I click on preview, I see the colors have come a bit more to life. Hue saturation can also be used for color adjustments. I will click on reset to undo and zoom in to 100% by pressing Ctrl and scrolling forward. On top of the window, the color wheel is represented. Here we can see the complementary color of red, which means on the other side of the color circle, is cyan. The complementary color of green is magenta, and the complementary color of blue is yellow. In Hue Saturation, I can rotate the color wheel. If I rotate, I will shift the hues. I can do this for all colors at the same time, but also for individual colors. Let's say I want to make the pipes of the organ more blue. Because the pipes are cyan, I will select cyan in the color wheel. I can rotate the color wheel in two directions, clockwise and counterclockwise. If I rotate clockwise, I will move cyan colors in the direction of green, yellow, or red. And if I go counterclockwise, I will move cyan colors to blue, magenta, or red. So to shift cyan to blue, I go counterclockwise. To do this, I drag the hue slider to the right. I can see the image change as I drag. And in the color wheel, I can see cyan has been changed to blue. I click on preview to compare. I click on OK and press Ctrl+0 to see the whole image. Let's look at the second example. I open mountains. Let's say I want to make the red trees green, like the other trees. I zoom in to 100% by pressing Ctrl and scrolling forward. And I open Hue Saturation. I want to adjust the red trees, so I will select the reds. To shift red to green, I go counterclockwise. I drag the hue slider to the right. I can also fill in degrees. A single color shift, for example from red to yellow, is 60 degrees. Shifting two colors is 120 degrees. And going to the other side, which is going to the complementary color, is 180 degrees. I want to shift two colors, so a 120 degree shift. I select the text in the Hue entry field, type 120 and press Enter. As we can see, not all our reds have changed. To adjust this, you use Overlap. Increasing overlap will expand the range of colors that are shifted. If I drag overlap to the right, more and more red colors will become green. I zoom out by pressing Ctrl and scrolling backward. As we can see, I have also made the roof of the house green. How to deal with this will be discussed in the chapter about selections. The leaves are green now, but a bit too saturated. So I will decrease the saturation by dragging the slider to the left. To improve the match with the leaves at the right, I will shift a bit more to yellow and bring the hue to about 90. We have now changed the red leaves to green leaves. For the last example, open girl. The girl wears a blue shirt. I would like to make the shirt darker. I click on blue in the color wheel. I increase overlap to include all blues. Now I drag lightness to the left to darken the shirt. I will also decrease saturation a bit. And if I wanted to change the color of the shirt, I could drag the hue slider. In the next lecture, we will look at the color picker.